Hey guys, we are in the basement. Today we're gonna do a John's Arcade on the road, guys. You know what? We're gonna be getting in the car and we're gonna be taking a ride to pick up a new game. That's right, guys, and this is not any game. Let me tell you something. This is one of the most iconic, game-changing arcade games of all time. I mean, we're talking about Dragon's Lair, guys. This is a LaserDisc game. Now, I've done a Dragon's Lair review. If you guys remember, we went up to Fun Spot, and the Dragon's Lair that was at Fun Spot was actually running Daphne. Now, Daphne is kind of like a LaserDisc emulator, okay? And the one I'm picking up today is actually 100% all original, right? It's got the original LaserDisc player in it, and it's still working. So I'm very excited to see this thing. I've only seen photos, and I think the condition of it is pretty good, but I have really no idea. So we're gonna get in the car, we're gonna pick up my buddy Ted, because Ted's gonna help me get the game out of this guy's basement. We're gonna go to this guy's house, we're gonna look at it. If it looks good, we're gonna buy it. And we're gonna bring it back here and bring it down to the basement, guys. And I really hope it's everything it's supposed to be, because let me tell you, I really would love to have a Dragon's Lair down here. I mean, how badass would it be to have a Dragon's Lair? So anyway, let's stop talking. Let's get in the car. Let's go get Ted. And then let's go down to this guy's house and check out the Dragon's Lair and hopefully bring that thing back here to the basement. All right, guys, let's go. Ted's house here, and Ted actually just picked up not that long ago a pretty rare game, dude. Are you like the only person that has this? This is a Capcom Saturday Night Slam Masters, and if you guys can see it, it's two linked cabinets. It's a four-player wrestling game, right?
Right.
And you guys can see it's big, but it's got two sets of controls for up to four players. You're missing a couple parts. Maybe you guys, someone out there has these parts. He's missing the metal that goes in between here. And then there's a big marquee that goes across the top that you actually have, though.
I have the marquee, yeah.
The marquee lights up, obviously, right?
Yes.
And is it bolts here and here, goes right across?
Right, yeah.
So it's supposed to look like this. He's got it on his phone.
Yeah.
Dude, that thing is epic, man. So you're missing the metal that goes right in the middle there, the upper metal. So if anyone out there has that metal, let us know.
That artwork, yeah.
Or even the artwork, because that's like the only thing you need to finish this, right?
Yeah.
I mean, there's none of these in existence, wouldn't you agree? I mean, this is the kind of game that operators destroy, right? It's so big. Huh? Convert it, right.
Yeah, once the batteries die, commit suicide.
And, oh, they have suicide boards?
Yeah, it has two suicide batteries in the board set.
Oh, really?
And either it stops making money or it dies and...
Right, or they convert it to two different games.
Yeah.
Because these are essentially Capcom Big Blue cabinets, right?
They are.
And it's two of them linked, and then they're connected with these metal pieces in the middle, and then you can look down there, you can see that little wire loom that's connecting them together, right?
Right, right. The board sits in this cab, and it's like a splitter, so it sends a video and sends power to the other cabinet.
It does.
Yeah, the cabinet really, it doesn't have much of a harness in there.
This one?
Yeah, very minimal. This one really has everything.
Right, so this one's got the PCB and all that, and then it just sends the controls probably to here for the wires for the controls and the monitor, right? And sound?
Yeah.
This is awesome, dude. So how's this game? I mean, Ted's a big like Street Fighter guy. I mean, is this?
It's like the Street Fighter.
It's like a Street Fighter wrestling game.
Yeah.
Because I noticed that the announcer's like the same Street Fighter guy.
They are.
Yeah.
They are. Capcom had a big tournament in, I think, 1993.
Yeah.
You know, if you won your local arcade, you went to a regional, you went to the regional.
For this game.
Yeah. And my friends actually went from Western Mass down to New Jersey.
Yeah.
They won the New Jersey one.
Did they really?
Capcom flew them out to California.
To compete in this game.
Yep. And they made it all the way to the finals, and they got their butts whooped. They didn't
really.
They didn't know one of the techniques in the game is to go up on the ropes.
Yeah.
Hit the pin button a few times and you power up.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, and you could do some serious damage.
So it's got attack, jump, and pin. And the pin button, you use that in the game as a fighting move? It's not just like an end move?
No, it's just pin.
It is, yeah. Like to pin the guy down.
Yeah, or if he's facing, you know, if he's laying face up, you can just pin him right away.
Right.
If he's facing down, you kind of roll him over, but a lot of strategy. You know, you obviously want to save your teammate if he's getting pinned, or, you know, you can tag team up. So a lot of little strategies. Everybody's got regular moves, special moves, you know, Street Fighter type of moves.
Right.
It was just, became completely addicted to the game. And
you had to have it.
Haven't seen it in like 20 some odd.
You had it shipped here too, which was not trivial because this thing's a monster.
Yeah.
I mean, it's two whole cabinets.
Yeah.
So, awesome, Tebow. Thanks for showing us this, dude. Yeah. This thing is sick.
Okay, they got a tip line here.
Are you serious?
Yeah. I wonder
so
if
for that... for game tips, call 1-900. Do they still have 900 numbers?
I don't know.
680-2583. Call charges are 95 cents for the first minute. No way.
This is like pre-internet days, right?
Yeah, right.
You have to do a call a number.
Call a tip line. That's funny. And you got these. Oh, dude.
What do you think I got my handle from?
So Ted's handle on the internet is Gunlock. I never knew what it meant. And look at here.
Yeah.
I didn't...
Yeah, no.
I never knew that. Okay, so you named yourself after one of these characters. Oh, you had to get this game, dude.
Yeah.
Your internet handle's Gunlock. That's hilarious. We got Gunlock and El Stingray, Alexander, Mike Hagger, the Great Oni, King Rastamon, Biff Slamkovich, Titanic Tim... Jumbo Flapjack and the Scorpion. Who's your favorite character? Is it Gunlock?
Gunlock and Grader.
And who?
Grader.
That guy?
Yeah.
Oh, his nickname's the Grader. Wow, dude, that's pretty awesome. Well, Ted, thanks for showing us this game. We gotta hit the road, man. We gotta go get that Dragon's Lair. Looking forward to this?
Sure. Yeah.
And Ted's actually letting me borrow his Van Halen album. Cover, because we're going to put the laser disc in this, because I'm worried about transporting the laser disc in the player, so we're going to stick it in this. So thanks, Ted.
Yeah.
Dude, I loved this album, by the way. I mean, I used to stare at this artwork, too, and just like, I mean, 1984. Yeah, I was smoking cigarettes. Yeah. What a great album, dude. That's like the best Van Halen album ever, so. All right, let's hit the road. Ted, we're driving.
Well,
are you excited?
You're driving.
I'm driving. So, Ted, what is your opinion of Dragon's Lair? Do you have one? Do you like it?
Yeah, it was a groundbreaking game, you know?
Yeah.
It really brought that cartoonish, you know?
That Disney-like animation in a video game.
Yeah, there's nothing like it at the time.
What I remember about it is that it was 50 cents, and I couldn't afford it.
Yeah, or was it 50 cents to start and continue, or was it 50 to start?
I don't remember.
Continue?
Was it a quarter to continue?
Yeah, maybe if we were lucky.
Because I remember like going to the 7-Eleven, and they had Dragon's Lair and then like some other game next to it, and I would have like a buck, and I'm like, all right, well, I could play Dragon's Lair twice and lose, or play the other game four times. And I was horrible at the game and still am. Were you good at it?
No.
Could you finish it? No?
No. I think, just like you, it was too expensive to get good at it.
Yeah, because I would watch like the older kids play it, and I don't know, I'm actually looking forward to getting good at the game and figuring it out. I wonder if it's going to have a lot of replay value once I finish it. What do you think?
Is it linear? Is it more than one path?
I don't know how linear it is, to be honest. So.
Yeah, I do remember the time. There was nothing like it before it. I mean, it was...
Yeah, and there was nothing. It was
a huge improvement on graphics.
I think it was the first LaserDisc game. And I mean, there was a bunch of LaserDisc games after it, like Space Ace and Firefox. Remember Atari did Firefox?
Yeah.
Did you ever see that movie with Clint Eastwood?
Possibly. Something with like a blank ship or whatever.
It was like a cool like stealth plane or something. And he stole it from Russia or something. I don't remember.
Yeah, I don't know.
All right.
If I start talking about it, I'm going to get that mixed up with, like, Airwolf.
I know. Airwolf was the helicopter.
Yeah.
Wasn't that a TV show with Michael...
What was the guy's name? Hammer or something? I don't know. All right, let's keep driving. We're almost there. All right, guys, here is the game. So this is Bill. Hey, Bill. I'm buying the game from Bill. So Bill, tell me the story. When did you get this game? How did you get this game? You know? Do you remember?
I got this game. I want to say I had this game for about 7 years now.
Okay.
7-8 years.
Did it come like from an operator or something?
It came from, no, it was a private collector.
Oh, it was?
Yep, he had it. He had bought it from an operator. He had it for a few years.
Okay.
It was good shape. Everything
it is in
worked.
Good shape, yeah.
And
you haven't done anything to it.
I haven't done a thing to it.
Right.
Had some good luck.
That's great. So it looks good. It's got the original Cinematronics coin door, which is awesome. Needs a new control panel overlay. Not a big deal. Quarter Arcade actually has new CPOs. Side art's missing. Looks like it was on here at one point, or it came off, huh?
Yeah, you can actually see it because you can see some art behind the bullets.
Okay, yeah, I can see that.
I think the original just got pulled.
And it's got like the original like leathery vinyl on the sides. That's pretty awesome. That would be a heck of a. It'd be pretty hard to recreate that. It's like a leather.
Yeah.
And the front too, man. The cabinet's nice. And it's got the LED scoreboard and marquee's in good shape. So let's take a peek inside. Real clean. It's got the original LaserDisc player, which is crazy. Those usually don't last.
No, I know they don't last. Yeah. I could imagine how the operators move these around from location to location.
Yeah.
And they just got beat up on the back of trucks.
Yeah, and I think we're going to try to pull the LaserDisc player out before we take it out of here. I want to get the disc out at the very least. Because I've heard you shouldn't transport it with the disc in it. Yeah. We brought a Van Halen 1984 album. We're going to stick it in that.
Oh, nice. Appropriate.
Yeah. 1984 album. Yeah. Cool. So can we turn it on?
Of course.
Yeah. So does the display have an issue, or is that just in the boot sequence?
It must be a sequence
okay.
or something that's booting up.
I see, okay.
You see it'll eventually get to zero, and it's on free play right now. So it goes through a sequence.
Gotcha.
As we see the game come up, and then you'll see everything start at zero.
Sweet. So there it is, man. It's on free play?
Free play.
Is it ready to play now?
Yeah, ready
to play. That's so awesome. Wow, man. I'm so bad at this game. Can you finish this game, Bill?
No.
You can't? You've never finished it?
No.
Really?
It's a very difficult game.
Whoa. Yeah, I'm kind of looking forward to getting good at it.
Woo!
Well, you're good.
Yeah, I could go through about a handful of scenes. Forward. Forward. Oh! That one little to the right. It's been a while.
Yeah. Man, the cabinet looks great.
So we could do the wraps. The wraps are pretty easy. What's this? Hold it for me.
Awesome. Oh, you got one life left? You hit sword there? Is that what you did?
I don't know if it's sword or hop back.
Oh, okay.
Hop back, but.
Awesome, dude. So yeah, it works and it looks great. Yeah, dude, we're definitely taking it home today. What else you got here? You got a missile command, a berserk, asteroids.
Pretty nice asteroids.
Yeah. What pin is this?
Nice original Space Invaders here.
What's that pin?
Oh, this is a Harley Davidson 3rd edition chrome.
Oh, sweet.
Yep.
A stern. Is that a Stern?
Nice one. That's a reconditioned Pac-Man.
Nice cocktail. Sweet. Nice. So you're in the middle of remodeling. You're
gonna repo art. Yeah, we ripped up.
Put your arcade back up.
Some of the laminate stuff. We're gonna go ahead and do some tile.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Should have did in the first place.
Oh, yeah, the little arcade games.
Yeah.
Old school. The Zaxxon one.
Yeah. You know, crazy.
Yeah, I did too.
I kept them all, but
I didn't.
No.
The one I missed the most was Donkey Kong Jr. Do you remember that one?
Oh yeah.
The orange one with the
odd shape. Yeah. A little longer, shorter.
And you had to have like a light that shine through the top. I used to bring that with me camping, and I would play it like forever.
Yeah.
Like it was a DS or something. So, all right, man, we're going to take it. So let's load it up. Let's get it out of here. We're going to, I want to take that laser disc out.
Okay.
So I'm not sure what we need to do to open that up. So, all right, let's get that out.
Yeah, just with the age.
Yep. So before we go, we're just checking out his Tapper here. Pretty bitching. You got to love Tapper. Looks nice. And you got a crane machine. That's awesome. The toy taxi. Hey, Teddy's got some CPS 2 boards here. Three.
Old school, like Big Choice ones.
Ted?
Yeah, Big Choice.
CPS boards.
Yeah.
Which games are those? You know?
X-Men versus Street Fighter.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had a few.
What's that one that you have, the Street Fighter one? Turbo?
Super Street Fighter Turbo.
Yeah, I want that board. All right, well, let's get this Dragon's Lair taken care of. All right, we figured out how to open up this thing. It's a drawer, which wasn't really obvious at first, but we want to get the laser disc out. Should we go get the Van Halen album first?
Sure.
Yeah, all right, be back. Let's give this thing power, and then press.
Well, you gotta pull.
Is the game on? This is weird, this is back. Okay, it's on. So we press this. All right. All right, there's the disc. Okay, so. You hold that?
Yeah.
And I'm gonna get the disc. I don't know why, but I'm actually nervous. Pull this out more. I can turn it off now.
Yeah, turn it off, yeah. Did you even need to?
I just wanna see. All right, let's get the disc out of here. Okay. So here's the disc.
That's a thick disc.
Yeah, it is. Carefully get it in there. So the bottom's got, don't touch the bottom. The bottom has got the data. Okay. All right, we got that in our Van Halen album here. I think I'm gonna leave the player in. What do you think, Ted? It's bolted to the top. As long as I'm not rough with it, it should be fine. Yeah, let's just leave the player in. I mean, it's too. It's four screws to get it out, though. It's not a big deal to take out. What do you think? What would you do, Ted? Should we leave it in or take it out? What do you think? Should we take it out?
Obviously, it's up to you. I mean, is it?
It's four screws. It's four screws.
Oh, whoa.
Oh, no, no. It's loose, dude.
It rips up?
Oh, we definitely are taking the player out.
Yeah.
Oh, the player's just sitting on a shock mount. Oh, I see. Okay, we have to take it out. It's not bolted down.
Jeez.
Okay, good thing we caught that. All right, so let's just make sure this game is unplugged. All right, so we should take a photo of the connections. Because there's two wires here. One's top, one's bottom. Is that audio left and right, maybe?
Yes, it is.
Okay. So maybe we can label which one goes where. So it's pretty straightforward. There's a coax, and then there's this thing.
Yeah, just be careful with the coax. Looks like it's a little frayed there.
We're ready. Okay, so the coax is disconnected. And then, do you think left and right really matters? Should we label this one?
I don't have a pen or anything.
All right, maybe he's got a Sharpie. We can mark the top one. Hey, Bill, do you have a Sharpie? Okay, so I marked the, looks like the audio out. The top one's got the black on it. So Ted, can you lift this thing out? We gotta disconnect the power. All right. I don't think it's bolted down at all. I think it's just sitting on that shock mount.
I'll slowly lift it up and we'll see what happens here.
Yeah, it's not even bolted down.
There's a little plate.
It just sits on that shock mount.
Sits in there.
Yeah.
So it doesn't.
So, yeah. the feet go in the holes.
Yeah.
But this thing's got rubber, it's like a shock absorber.
Yeah, it's got, yeah.
Yeah. Which is fine as long as you don't transport it on its back, which is what we're gonna do. So.
Yeah. Oh, good move taking it out.
Yeah.
Look at the size of that thing.
That thing is a big LaserDisc player. Can we see
Pioneer.
The front? It's a Pioneer commercial. Is it commercial? Holy crap. LD, wow. And they make a board that you can get now so you can use more reliable players.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm probably gonna, I'm gonna roll OG for a while, but I probably will upgrade it eventually. All right, so let's get this thing on the cart and get it in the car. All right, we're all loaded up, and unfortunately there is no room for the LaserDisc player.
Oh, yeah, there's room all right.
So it's on Ted's lap. But that thing's gold, man. We can't risk putting it back here with the game. So, dude, I am jazzed. That thing was way nicer than I thought. It's in great shape.
Yes.
I put a new control panel overlay and side art on it, and I'm done. And I just gotta hope, pray to God that this thing keeps working. That LaserDisc player, that thing's a monster. So, all right, let's hit the road, guys. So Ted and I were talking about his Slam Masters. Is that what it's called? Saturday?
Yeah. Saturday Night Slam
Masters. Saturday Night Slam Masters. If anyone knows where he can find high-res scans of that artwork, anything, if anyone out there has that cabinet, he really needs those metal pieces that go in the middle there, or just a high-res image or scan. If anyone has that stuff, man, please look me up. Because that's the only thing he needs to finish that game. Super rare, man. Ted, that thing is so badass.
It's something, all right.
You can't even get that in your house, can you?
No.
No?
No.
Can you get the individual big blues down the stairs or no?
Nope.
You can't?
and I knew that going into the deal.
You did?
Yeah.
So you gotta wait for your next house?
Yeah, before I have to buy a house to fit that game.
To fit that game.
Yeah,
pretty much. Anyway, all right, we're still driving. Ted's still holding the LaserDisc player.
If somebody works at Capcom or something, you know, that has access to that artwork,
yeah.
I don't have the license or, yeah.
You would think that Capcom must have some files or books or something with that artwork.
From 1993.
Yeah.
Who knows what the hell they had. It could have been hand-drawn.
Right.
Sent it off to a printer and they just did a run.
And that was it.
Made the game, released it.
Yeah.
And that's it. You know, that's probably it. But
right.
I think I can find the artwork to those middle pieces. It's like instructions on how to play it. I think the characters and all that, I think I can find in like the Super Nintendo manual. So
yeah,
maybe I can,
you can recreate it.
Have somebody, some graphic designer kind of make something. But I figured, you know, these games were broken apart.
Converted.
And these panels might be sitting on an operator's shelf or in some warehouse. So
yep.
I would pull up. There's a bounty out there, you know. I would be willing to pay somebody to find these pieces, no doubt.
Yeah. You guys heard that. Ted's willing to pay you for your time
absolutely.
If you could find these metal parts.
Yeah, contact John.
Because I think Ted might, you might have like one of the only one of those games, right? Have you seen anyone else with that game anywhere?
No.
No?
No one has. I mean, they're, you know, the warehouse that I got these out of, there was another set of these games, but the control panels are ultra rare. You know, I'm gonna have them scanned and preserved, but really it's the big tournament marquee is very limited. And those metal
center pieces, yeah.
They're just super rare. That's, yeah.
All right, guys, so if you guys know where any of that Saturday Slam Masters artwork is, or even the pieces, let me know so I can tell Ted.
Yeah, it'll be worth your time if you find them.
All right, well, let's keep driving. Dragon's Lair is almost home. All right, guys, we got it home, man, and I gotta tell you, I'm like besides myself. I haven't really been this excited about getting a game in a while, and this thing's in great shape. I think I'm gonna just bring it into the basement. I'm not touching this thing. You know, it's got the original like leatherette vinyl here. I mean, you can't replace that. So I'm gonna clean it up real quick. The marquee, I wanna take a magic eraser to it and see if I can just kind of brighten it up a little bit. I can tell it's a little dingy just for being, or you know, whatever. It's, this thing's like 30 years old, but I think if we take a magic eraser, we can kind of just kind of brighten this thing up a little bit. Yeah, look at all that stuff that's already coming off. There's probably like, you know, 30 years of nicotine and stuff on here. And I'm just gonna clean this thing up a little bit, and I gotta find someone to help me get this in the basement. And then we'll go downstairs and we'll play us some Dragon's Lair, man. I haven't put the LaserDisc player back on yet. I have to admit, that LaserDisc player scares the hell out of me. Like, in a major way, man. And by the way, how badass is this artwork? I gotta get the new control panel overlay and the side art, but I mean, the artwork is so great, man. I mean, so awesome. I mean, this was done by Don Bluth, who was like an ex-Disney guy. I mean, this guy, Don Bluth, did a whole bunch of movies too in the 90s. Like, I think he did American Tail. So the guy that did this stuff, he just wasn't any guy, you know? He wasn't just any old animator or artist. I mean, he was the real deal, man. I mean, you basically had this Disney caliber guy doing the artwork and animation for a video game. It's just spectacular. So I think that's looking pretty good there. I should take some Simple Green to it. But Magic Eraser is awesome. You can buy this at the grocery store. It's like this sponge. It's like a very super high grit sandpaper, and it's pretty safe. And I use it all the time on control panel overlays, which is what this material is very similar to that's on the marquee up here. I don't even know if the marquee light was on when we were at Bill's house. I don't remember. Just trying to... Okay, I'm gonna get some Simple Green and a paper towel. Hang on. So I can't really tell. Does it look better? Kinda does. So I'm gonna clean the game up. I mean, it was in the guy's basement, which was a nice house, a nice basement, so it's not like this thing was in a, but look at that. Yeah. It's kinda nicotine smoke stains. That thing was definitely dirty. It's already looking kind of brighter. And I noticed the top was really dusty. So I'm just gonna give this thing a nice Simple Green bath before we bring it in the basement. And I gotta go find someone to help me, because there's no way I can get this game in the basement by myself. So let's just keep, I'm gonna go wet this some more and then we'll keep scrubbing it. All right, I just like gave this thing a Simple Green bath, and it's a lot cleaner. You could see it was pretty filthy. It definitely needed a good cleaning. So it's about ready to go in the basement. The one thing I do want to do, though, while we're in the garage, I want to clean the monitor, because I have no idea if it's dirty or not. And I just rather do it in the garage before we bring it down. And then once we get it in the basement, I'm going to take some time to adjust the monitor, because I didn't like how the monitor looked, and I'm hoping I can just adjust it. It had a 4900 in it, which is good. I love that monitor. It's got a Wells Gardner. I'm not really too sure if it's ever been capped. I think it's all original. Where the hell are the latches in here? So I'm looking for the latches for the control panel. Where are they? The hell? Oh, is it screw? No, it can't be. It is. There's thumb screws. That's weird. Uh, All right, let me get these thumb screws off here. Looks like there's two of them. It's kind of a weird setup. And I just dropped one of the thumb screws. So there's a thumb screw to the left and to the right, which is unusual because I've never... It's kind of a different kind of setup for a control panel. Because they're on the side, not on the bottom. I've seen thumb screws before, but they're usually on the bottom, not through the sides of the cabinet. Okay. All right, so here's the inside. Now I'm gonna be removing, get that thumb screw. I'm gonna be pulling the control panel off at some point because I'm gonna redo the overlay, and this joystick's all rusted, this Wico 8-way, and we'll sand this down. I'm not gonna do it now. I'll just bring the game in the basement the way it is, and then I'll work on it in the basement with the control panel overlay and the side art. Let's see. Yeah, the monitor's pretty dirty, so let me get some Windex and we'll clean that guy up. So I'd rather do all this in the garage. Yeah. It's somewhat dirty. Let's take the bezel off. Even if you have the games in a clean basement, you can still get this dust, because I've had games in my basement, you know, for 3, 4, 5 years, and I've pulled them out and the monitors were filthy, because these things are just like magnets, and it doesn't, you don't necessarily have to have a dirty environment or house for these things to get filthy. Let's just kind of clean all this up in here. I guess once you tighten this down, it'll stay in place. So let me get those thumb screws and we'll put this back together, and then we're gonna bring this thing down to the basement. I gotta go call a friend, and this game's ready for the basement, guys. Let's bring it down. Alright guys, the game is in the basement. Big thanks to my buddy Mike, who came over to help me get it down here. But here it is! And now we gotta get it back together. Put the LaserDisc player in, which kind of scares the hell out of me, to be honest. But so the game's gonna go right here. This was the space I was reserving for Journey. So now I need to find space for Journey. I do think Kix is gonna leave, guys. We'll see what happens. I don't know, I might move the freezer into the garage. I don't want to get rid of anything. I love these games. They're my friends. All right, so let's get the LaserDisc player hooked back up. Let's turn it on. Oh, I can't believe I have a freaking Dragon's Lair, man. I'm in disbelief. So we're going to have to pull that drawer out and then just reconnect the LaserDisc player, which shouldn't be really a big deal. As long as I'm careful and smart about this, this shouldn't really be much of a problem at all. So, let me get down here. Okay, so we gotta get this drawer open again, and there were some thumb screws over here. And it looks like this monitor, I don't know, it looks all original. It's a 4900, which I said in the garage is good, because I love that monitor. So I might cap that thing. You know, I do have a brand new in box Hap Vision Pro monitor that I'm very tempted to throw in here, but man, that monitor is clean. God, this game is so clean inside, man. All right, so let's pull the drawer out. Okay. Just like so. All right, so let me grab the LaserDisc player. And we'll throw that in there. So the LaserDisc has these feet that go in these holes on this little shock absorber plate. All right, easy enough. So let's make all of our connections. I mean, can you imagine if I didn't disconnect that LaserDisc player? It's clear to me that there's no other way to move this game. You gotta disconnect it before you move it. So we've got a little coaxial cable here. That's gonna go on here. Okay, that's connected. We have this audio cable right here, and remember at the guy's house I marked black for the top one. So that's one, and that's two. All right, and then we have this ribbon cable that's gonna go on here. Just like so. And then we have to make our power connection, which is this little two-pin Molex, like so. All right, that should be it. So now we gotta turn the game on and open the LaserDisc player. So let me grab the LaserDisc and let me get the power plug. Okay, I got the LaserDisc and I got a power cable. So this has like a power supply type connection like you'd find on a PC. So we're just gonna put this on here. All right, let's turn the game on. Let's open up the LaserDisc player. Come on, open. Open. There we go. All right, so let's turn it off. Okay, so I gotta be super careful here, man, because this LaserDisc scares the hell out of me. The fact that this game is still working, guys, you gotta understand, is a freaking miracle, okay? It's got the original LaserDisc player in here, which is unheard of. And I don't know if I'm gonna keep the original LaserDisc player, we'll see. Now, this LaserDisc needs to be cleaned. It's okay. I'm afraid to touch it. I'm gonna Google like how to clean LaserDiscs, but I'm not touching this thing. So I'm guessing, oh shit, what side goes down? This side must be up, it's gotta be. Because it's reading the data on this side. So let's come in here and just carefully stick this thing in here. All right, it's in. Ah, now it's in. Okay, let me kind of show you guys how it looks in there. It's a little nerve-wracking, but you can see how it looks in there. Pretty cool, huh? So it's almost like a record player. An old record player. So, okay, let's close the lid. All right. And let's slide the drawer back. Because we're hooked up now. And we should be able to slide this back. Make sure none of the wires are getting pinched or something here. So let's slide this all back carefully. Paying attention to our wires. I think I'm getting some resistance here. Alright, that's good. And then I'll do those wing nuts in a second. Okay, so let's turn the game on. Oh God, this better still work, I'll tell you that much. All right, so. Okay, I was wondering if the marquee light was lit and lighting, and it is. Okay, that's good. All right, so we're just gonna sit here. It looks like it's doing its thing. I'm sure it still works. I mean, I was extra careful. Okay, it does. All right, so I want to adjust the monitor. It looks a little washed out, I think. I'm not really sure. Thank God it's still working.
On your mark.
Make sure we got sound. We do. So the top here, is that like a tracking thing? What is that? Is that like an old VHS tracking scenario? So we've got some volume knobs on the inside. Okay. Not sure what to make of that top there. Could probably adjust that off. Looks like... Okay. Well, I think what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to get a mirror and I'm going to start adjusting the monitor. Okay, I went and got a mirror here and I'm just going to go back here and just start turning knobs till I think the picture looks better. Right now I'm just adjusting the colors. I don't know, it just looked really washed out to me. And I probably should cap the monitor at some point.
On your mark.
How we doing? Does it look better? I think it looks pretty good. So that top is bothering me. I wonder if I can adjust. Let me see what this does. Oh, I see it's adjusted all the way. There we go. That's gone. Got it like that. I wonder if I should turn the flyback down just a hair. It already looks better than it did. Boy, that looks pretty good actually. I think the flyback needs to come down just a notch. That's the focus. There. Oh yeah, that looks way better, man. That looks damn good. It's a good looking monitor, actually. Yeah, that looks tons better. The flyback was just turned up too much. Just kind of playing with the color pots. I don't know, guys. What do you think? I think that looks pretty damn good. Let's see how it looks. Ah, it still looks a little washed out. So on the neck, there are color pots, and that's what I'm adjusting right now. Right there. Does that look washed out? It does, doesn't it? I'm gonna keep playing with this. Okay, I think I got the picture looking pretty good, actually. I do wanna show you guys, there's a bunch of pots back here. I just kinda wanna show you basically how this all is working. All right, so we have our monitor. This is a Wells Gardner 4900, great monitor. And by the way, it's clean as hell, man. I mean, just look how nice this monitor looks. Okay, and then there's this board over here. This is some kind of video card that's converting the coaxial video that's coming from the player to CGA, I guess. And then this board right here has adjustments, tint, color, and contrast. And I played with those three. There's two other pots. One says luminosity bias, I guess. And then there's a pot over here. I didn't touch those two. That one says APC. I'll research that. And then we got another pot in the back, that blue pot. I didn't touch that one either. I just touched these three because they were easy to get to. Tint, color, and contrast. That one that's back there, I don't really know what that is. But, So let's take a look in this game anyway and just kind of see what's in here. Over here, it looks like this is the power supply, an isolation transformer. They mounted it on the side of the cabinet because the LaserDisc player is on the floor, so they had to mount it inside on the wall. And then over here is, I guess, a ROM board of some sort, probably the audio amp, stuff like that. I'm not really sure what the function of this stuff is. Now, I do know that they make a replacement board that I might get that allows you to swap out the LaserDisc player with a more, slightly more modern one and more reliable. And also, with this new board that you can get, it has the ROM data for Space Ace. So that means that I could get the Space Ace LaserDisc and throw it in here, you know, if I want to mix it up. And I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to look at getting that board. And I might look at getting a different LaserDisc player. This one's fine. This is a Pioneer one, LVD 1000 or something. And it's amazing that it's still working. This LaserDisc player that's in here does not have a good reputation. And I've heard that if you upgrade to a different LaserDisc player, because this board that they sell allows you to use like 10 different models of LaserDisc players, and many of them are considered to be better, more reliable, and also they have smoother transitions when you're selecting the different tracks, because this game is essentially playing tracks off of the LaserDisc, and that's how it works. Yeah, I'm pretty damn happy, man. The marquee is lit up. That looks good. I did notice that these coin door bulbs are out. Why don't we just change those out real fast? Trivial, but not right. So let's see what we got going on here. I don't know if these are 12 volt or 5 volts. We'll find out soon enough. I got some bulbs right here. So I'm going to put some 4-4 bulbs in there. Let's see if this works. Is that a 4-4? I don't think it is. No, that's a 1. That's a 12 volt bulb. So that it was so dim, I could tell right away that it's 5 volts. So let's put a 5 volt 4-4 bulb in here, and if you guys can actually see what's going on. All right, let's put this in. There, that looks way better. Just the little tiny things, you know. I just want to these little details actually I live for. Like coin door lights and marquee lights. It's part of the package, you know. All right, that's way better, man. Now that looks good. Let's turn the light off. Oh. Guys, I gotta tell you, I'm kind of besides myself right now. I honestly... Yeah, my stupid microphone disconnected here, evidently. So anyway, what I'm saying here is, yeah, I can't believe I have this Dragon's Lair. So I'm gonna put the back door on, and then we're gonna move it into the space. I did measure here, this is like 27 inches. And I think Dragon's Lair is 25 inches wide. So the game's gonna like perfectly fit in that space. So I'm going to go ahead and put the back door on, and we're going to move the game into its new home. And let me tell you guys, I'm totally jazzed that I have this game. I honestly can't believe that I have a freaking Dragon's Lair. So anyway, let's get it in its new home. Okay, guys, we have Dragon's Lair in its new home. What do you think? How's it look? I think it looks pretty bitchin', man. I can't believe I have a freaking Dragon's Lair! Talk about a cool-ass game and knocking on every piece of wood I could possibly find right now. It's working, and it's original. Holy shit. My God. Now I need to get good at the game, so... So let's review. I need to get a new control panel overlay. This is not good. So that's fine. I'll order that today. I'm gonna order side art for it. even though you can't see it. That's all I'm gonna do to it, man. I'm gonna pull the control panel out, bring it to the garage. I'll clean the joystick shaft up because it's all rusted, and we'll pull it out, put side art on it, put the new overlay, and that's it, man. It looks pretty damn good. Maybe I'll get some new buttons. Who knows? It's got the original Cinematronics coin door. I mean, you can't beat that, right? Let me show you guys the controls in here. There is one thing I do need to set up, and that's like the difficulty and the dip switch settings. Because right now it's set to 5 guys. Oh, look at this. Okay, so we've got 2 volume knobs. I think one is for the beeps and one's for the disc. And then here's a meter. This game has 66,000 plays on it. So did this game make... So 25% of that is what about 15 grand? 13-ish? 13, 26. Oh God. What's 25% of 66? That's gonna be 22 times 4 is 13, 20. Don't you guys love when I try doing math live? So it's about $1,600? 16, it's about 1,700, 17 grand? Yeah, 17,000. So this game made $17,000? Is that possible? 66,000. Okay, I went and grabbed my calculator just to make sure. All right, so this game made $17,000. Now, what did they pay? Actually, no, because this is a 50-cent game. Whoa, it made double that. So it made $34,000. Really? Could that be? Could it have made that much money? So you can see there's a fan back there that is working, which is a good thing. So it's got a fan. There's a filter, which is interesting. So I don't know if I should change that filter that's down there. And then I need to look up the dip switch settings because there's some dip switches back here. And I'll do that later. I'll download the manual and see what it's all about. But God, I'm pretty damn stoked, guys. So why don't we, once I get the new overlay on here, man, this thing's gonna be perfect. So why don't we set up the tripod and why don't we attempt to play a game? And you know, I just got the game, so this is not gonna be a very good one. So when I get better at it, I'll do another gameplay video. But for now, let's give it a shot. I'll turn the light off. I know that we played this at Fun Spot, if you guys remember that. We did, because Fun Spot's got Dragon's Lair. However, it's Daphne. It's not original. So this is original. So, all right, let's start a game. Okay. So we have the controls here. We had an 8-way joystick and a button for the sword right there. Okay, so let's see what we do. I'm pushing forward. Okay, good. Pass that. Next level. And I think it randomizes the levels. It's never the same order twice. Press right, press left. Left, it's too late. And the game is set to 5 lives, and I don't know if that's the default. Forward. Oh, I suppose it's sword there. Boy, it's gonna be fun trying to figure out how to play this game, isn't it? This one, I never know which is the right one to get off on. Is it that one? Is it that one? Let's try that one. Did I do right? Did I? I think I did. Okay, good. All right, so, oh shit. Forward. Okay, good. Oh, this one. I remember this one when I was a kid. 1, 2, 3. Oh, yes. All right, so what do I do here? Sword? I wonder if I should go online and get like a book or something, download a guide. Oops. I don't know what I'm doing, guys. I'm gonna get good at this, I promise. Sword. Oops. Aren't the death animations just like amazing, by the way? So there you go. That's it, man. That's Dragon's Lair. And then when I get good at the game, maybe, if I do get good at the game, I'll make a real gameplay video. But today was really more about getting the game, getting it down here, and boy, am I honestly, I am so freaking happy I have this game. This is so badass. This game belongs down in this basement. It's a good game. All right, guys, that's it. So, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I had a lot of fun. I want to thank my friend Ted for coming with me and helping me get that game out of that guy's basement. Because Bill, the guy we bought it from, he had a pinched nerve in his back or something. So he asked that I bring someone to get it out, and Ted helped me out today. So Ted, thank you, buddy, for helping me. And by the way, guys, if you know anybody or anyone that might have that Slam Master artwork, and by the way, look at this crap. I gotta fix that. Tempest is acting up again. I got some new bit slicer chips. I'm hoping that fixes it. I don't think it's a socket issue. But anyway, if you guys know anybody anywhere that has that Saturday Slam Masters cabinet that Ted has, you know, with that big, those metal pieces in between the cabinets, Ted really needs that. And Ted loves that game, and he wants to restore it back to original, but he needs help. He can't find that artwork anywhere. He can't find anything on the internet about it. No one seems to have that game. So if you guys know that someone that has the game that could potentially scan their metal artwork, or if you guys just find some of that artwork on the internet somewhere, let me know, and I could forward that stuff to Ted. And then Ted said, hey, I'll give you guys some money. You know, he's putting a bounty on these parts, guys. So if you guys know anyone that has that stuff and wants to sell those parts, he'll throw some money your way to make it worth your time. So anyway, let me know. But anyway, that's it for the Dragon's Lair on the road video. If you guys have never subscribed to my little channel, now is a great time, because I release new videos every Sunday, and sometimes in between. I'm really trying to do two a week. It's tough, though. It's really tough. Because I'm doing two podcasts. That's right. I have two podcasts. One is called Video Game Outsiders at videogameoutsiders.com. And the other podcast is called Arcade Outsiders at arcadeoutsiders.com. And I do both of those podcasts live every Tuesday night, starting at 9 p.m. Eastern on allgames.com. And then also, you guys can listen anytime during the week. Go to iTunes and Stitcher and do a search for Video Game Outsiders or Arcade Outsiders. I've been doing Video Game Outsiders for like 10 years. And I do it with Coastal Michelle, Michelle Madison, and also Matt Bradford. And we have a gay old time. That is a fun podcast, guys. And then also I have the other podcast, Arcade Outsiders, is a slightly more stupid podcast I do with my collecting friends, Sean Fetish Boy Williams and Jao Senegaglia. So check those out. Arcade Outsiders, Video Game Outsiders on iTunes and Stitcher, and also live on allgames.com Tuesdays at 9 p.m. Okay, that's it. Subscribe, like, comment, all that good stuff. And we'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Later, and bye. Oh my God, look, it's here. So badass. See you guys. Bye.